I'm gonna record a quick video.
How bad are they visual?
Yeah, just a quick one.
New commission. Potentially could be a couple commissions. All right, put this on mute. What is up? Blake Jameson here. Today I wanted to do this quick video to talk about how I am preparing for Art Basel Miami, which I'm gonna be at in, I think we have about 2 weeks until the show that I'm doing, which is super exciting. So it's actually my first time going to Art Basel, and I will be showing there, which is crazy and super cool. Every single year I say that I wanna go, and then there's always, you know, December's a crazy month, especially for me, like Q4 with paintings as gifts and whatnot. Just haven't been able to make it happen yet, but this year I got this incredible opportunity to do an art show at the SLS South Beach. It's on December 4th from 6 to 10 p.m. So if you're seeing this and you wanna come, comment down below or DM me or whatever, and I will try to get you added. It is invite only, but we are expecting a pretty sick guest list. 400 to 600 people, a lot of athletes and agents and celebrities. It's gonna be dope. All right, so in this video, I just wanted to talk about what I am doing to prepare for Art Basel. I don't know if it's gonna work. Actually, yeah, it is gonna work for sure. Well, this is my first time. So this is what I'm doing every single step to prepare for Art Basel. Before we go any farther, I'm also doing this video because I have committed to produce more video content and post it for the last 5 years. I record almost everything, but it always just ends up in this folder and then I don't do much with it, and that's what I'm trying to change. So I'm posting 3 videos a week, every Monday, Wednesday, Friday, on YouTube. Make sure to subscribe so you get them. Till now, I've been doing a lot of time-lapse videos where it's just me painting and creating something from start to finish. Super cool. Check out this Russell Westbrook, for example. Ding! That's super dope. One of my favorite paintings that I've made this year. And that says a lot because it's the end of the year. Anyways, we'll get back to the Art Basel stuff. I was invited to do this art show at the SLS. There are 3 artists involved. It is a pop-up show. It's just one day, one night. I think it's gonna be freaking awesome. The reason that I was specifically invited is because they had a lot of people in like the fashion, entertainment, and kind of like, I guess, entertainment. Yeah, said that already. So I'm super pumped for the show, super pumped to check out other artists and what other people have going on at Art Basel. So if there are any events that you think that I should go to or things that I should check out, also comment down below right after you subscribe. So first of all, I need to paint 6 new athlete portraits for the show. Ideally, they are athletes that have some type of tie to Miami. So it could be that they play professional sports there. For example, Dwayne Wade. This one's gonna be super sick. Everything that I'm doing for the show is this 24 by 36. Traveling with paintings is important because I don't wanna ship the paintings there. I'm gonna check them as like a check bag on a plane, but I say bag. It's gonna be a box, a big box of a shit ton of paintings. That will be one of them. I'm also doing a painting of Dan Marino, and I printed out this. It was originally, at first this was going to be the stencil, but a friend of mine, Alexis Iacono, who is amazing, her dad is a sports photographer, worked with Sports Illustrated for many, many years, and did this amazing piece. It's an editorial piece on Dan Marino, and so he's got some incredible photographs that are not really out in the ether. Like that one I just got from Google, but she's linking me up with her dad that is super tight because it's a photo that not many people have seen. Also, because he's worked with so many incredible athletes, he's connected to Dan Marino. We're going to invite Dan to the show. Obviously, if he comes, that's going to be super dope. I have to choose six paintings to do, all with ties to Miami. So far, I've picked 3, and I'm still open about the other 3. I've got a lot of ideas in the works. So right now, I'm definitely doing Dwayne Wade, Dan Marino, and Sean Taylor from his time at University of Miami. So those 3 are locked down, but the other 3, because I need to bring at least 6, are still up for grabs. So if you have ideas of who I should paint, ties to Miami, comment down below. Dwayne The Rock Johnson is definitely a possibility. It might be nice to do some current players, so Jimmy Butler could be good. Any and every painting that I do for the show, I'm going to reach out to their people or the player themselves and invite them to the show. If they come to the show and can maybe like sign it, do a little photo thing, that would be super dope. If Dan Marino comes and he wants my painting, it's his. I'm going to give it to him. The other preparation, outside of just choosing which athletes that I need to paint for the show, and by the way, producing 6 works in the next 2 weeks is, it's not out of the question. I produce a ton of work, but that's all on top of commissions, holiday gifts, other things that I've got going on. So definitely random thing. So I've been listening to, while I was cutting the Dwayne Wade stencil, I've been listening to 64th Man. 64th Man on Audible. It's an Audible original, starring John Cena and Anna Chlumsky. Chlumsky. We're going to go with that. It's amazing. It's not exactly a book. They call it a series. It basically reads like a book, but it's got a full cast. So John Cena kills it. And actually, they just sent me this. It's like a crash dummy. So if I'm frustrated, could do like, you know, punchy drills. I do a lot of Audible evangelism. Yeah. I listen to audiobooks while I paint all the time. I'm going to go into the other things that I'm doing to prepare for Art Basel Miami. I'm going to use my phone because a good friend of mine recommended that I not only bring original paintings, but also have some small prints to sell for a price point that is easier to meet, I guess, than my original prices, and something that a businessman could, like, put in his briefcase, or her briefcase, business person, could put in their briefcase and bring home with them. I need to make sure and order all these prints so that I can bring them with me. I'll probably do 10 prints of each. I don't know if I'll do 8x10, 16x20, something like that. Pretty small so that someone could put it in their luggage and travel with it. Definitely got to get more business cards. When I moved to New York a year ago, I had a ton of business cards. I went through them so fast, and it is embarrassing for me to say, but I've been out of business cards for almost the whole year that I lived in New York. But I'm ordering new business cards for Art Basel, and I will do it through Moo cards so that I can have different pictures of my different paintings on the back of the card. So if somebody really likes the Dan Marino piece or the Dwayne Wade piece, I can give them a business card that has that picture and then my contact information. Beyond that, I'm also gonna do either one sheets or maybe like postcard size where I can show a bunch of different works, probably different than what I'm showing, just so that I can show people the variety of what I do. Business cards, faux show, gotta order those like today. Postcards, also ordering very soon. And then I need to display my work. I need to figure out how I'm going to display my work, which will be on easels. Since it's a pop-up show, we're not really rearranging the space. Everything is just going to be kind of modular, standalone. So I need to figure out how I'm going to get the easels either to Miami or buy them in Miami. So my thought process with the easels is if I can buy them locally in Miami when I get there, then that saves me at least one checked bag on the way there. I will have to bring a bag so that I can bring them back. I also don't want to get to Miami and then realize that no art stores have easels because everyone is in Miami for Art Basel. Maybe I order ahead of time for the local pickup at like a Blick so that they're reserved and sitting there. I'm not really sure yet. The other option would be ordering them online, like on Amazon, where they would be dirt cheap, and then have them shipped to the SLS where I could pick them up when I get there. That's probably what I'll do, but I'm not 100% sure. So going up until Art Basel, I'll be working 7 days a week, but this weekend I'm actually going to Philadelphia 76ers art show that they're putting on where I have a piece of art. I painted Hal Greer. I'll put the video right there. Bing. That'll be dope, but it also means that I will be away from my studio, away from New York for the next 2 or 3 days, and not being able to cut out the stencils for Art Basel. So once I get back Monday afternoon, it will be a grind, a sprint grind. It'll be a sprint to get everything done. That's it. So that's what I'm doing for Art Basel Miami 2019. If you think that I'm missing anything or have any other ideas, comment down below. Definitely looking for more opportunities. If there are other places that I can either show my art or other art shows that I should go to network with other artists or collectors or athletes or people, you let me know. I'm super stoked. I'm Blake Jamison, blakejamison.com. This is my video. Subscribe down below. I do them every Monday, Wednesday, Friday now, starting last week. And I haven't missed one yet, so